Hello, I'm Everest Pipkin, here with you today with the COSA Connectors project, where we highlight free and open source creative tools for making. These are not tutorials, but rather introductions. I'll walk you through what a tool is, how it might be used, how to access it, and why I think you might care about it. The tool I'd like to share with you today is called Bitsy. You might be asking yourself, what is Bitsy? Bitsy is a little editor for little games or worlds. The goal is to make it easy to make games where you can walk around and talk to people and be somewhere. Made by Adam Ledoux, with lots of ongoing contributions from the public, Bitsy has an active online community of users, hackers, and makers, including a friendly Discord and monthly game jams. Games made in Bitsy range wildly in their scope, size, and genre, but it works especially well for short narrative games, little vignettes, or games about being in one place and wandering around. Bitsy is defined by its constraints. It has limited interaction, only 3 colors, and very little programming. The pixel canvas is tiny. However, this simplicity is incredibly useful for making focused and deliberate ideas. It gives every choice a lot of weight. Because it's so simple, it is also a great tool for prototyping ideas or getting something down on paper right away. You can access Bitsy at ledoux.itch.io/bitsy or at ledoux.io/bitsy/editor. Again, this isn't a tutorial, but I want to demo the core functionality of the Bitsy interface. Bitsy runs right in a browser, and you can do all of your game building in these various windows. Each describes a particular tool or action. For example, the room window lets us place objects and characters in space. The paint window lets us draw our characters, backgrounds, and items. It's our canvas. The colors window lets you select the colors for each room. The dialogue window lets you add dialogue to characters and items, and so on. There are a lot of options inside of Bitsy, including branching narratives, dialogue trees, and even things like variables and win conditions. The community around Bitsy also has made dozens of hacks and modifications to Bitsy itself, including small modifications that add things like sound effects or a pet that follows you around, or total rewrites of the engine like Bitsy HD, a bigger Bitsy, and Bitsy 3D, which allows you to build 3D worlds. When you're done with your project, you can export your game to HTML and play it in a browser, or put it up on a website. Itch.io, the same website that hosts the Bitsy editor, has thousands of Bitsy games that you can play for inspiration. And once you've made your own game, you can upload it there or anywhere else for others to discover.